Hi everyone, 2023 was another huge year for Sapphire with the 2023.5 and the 2024 releases. Starting with 2023.5, we stripped out a lot of the old presets. We actually looked at all of the presets in a huge spreadsheet. It took us quite a while. We made a lot of the old tired effects obsolete, although they are still available if you do need them. And we replaced those with a lot of new looks. And we also updated presets to take advantage of the new parameter linking feature, which was also introduced in 2023.5. And parameter linking is particularly handy in these really big effects in Sapphire Effect Builder. You can see I've got loads of nodes in here. Just as a quick example, I've got a couple of distort chroma effects in here. And if you know anything about Builder, you'll probably know that you can make various parameters available in the host. You can see here I've got the amount parameter checked, so that's available inside the host. And if I click on this distort chroma here, you can see that also has an amount parameter, which is the same value. So in order to save me having two separate amount parameters in the host, what I can do is I can click on the stopwatch here, make this a driver, click on the second distort chroma, click on the stopwatch again, click on the link, and then I can choose that to be driven by the driver. So if I go back to the driver node and I make a change, that also changes the distortion amount for distort chroma 2. So you can make these really quick links which save a lot of time and also will declutter your host parameters inside your host. So very, very handy. I definitely recommend you take a look at parameter linking. A couple of other smaller things that were added in 2023.5 include a new favorites option. Over here in the effect list, if I click the star, then that becomes one of my favorites. And also the new quick menu. So if I hit the tab key, up pops a new quick menu. And here I can quickly search for an effect. For example, my favorite glow of all time, Ultra Glow. And I can quickly add that into my effect stack. So very, very handy new features introduced in 2023.5 inside of Builder. And to learn more about that, you can check out this tutorial, which dives deeper into those Builder features. With Sapphire 2024, we introduced two brand new effects, Sapphire Dust and Sapphire Pixel Mosh. You can use Sapphire Dust to create realistic and cinematic dust effects really fast. I've spent a lot of time using this effect. And besides dust, it's also great for things like embers and snow, for fast bokeh looks. And I also, of course, find it really useful inside of Sapphire Builder when combining it with other Sapphire effects. And we've created a whole ton of presets that you can use as a starting point. You can also learn more about Sapphire Dust by checking out this tutorial. And if you want to dive a bit deeper, you can check out my latest Understanding Dust tutorial. Sapphire Pixel Mosh is a brand new stylized effect, and you can use that to create some really amazing looking glitchy effects. I've only just started scratching the surface with this effect, but Ben's been diving really deep, and he's also recorded some expert tutorials for this, which includes tips and tricks on how to use it with the built-in Mocha Planar Tracker, and also how to combine it with other effects inside Sapphire Effect Builder. And created a whole bunch of different presets for this as well, so you can use those as a starting point. Another update included in Sapphire 2024 is the Time Effect update. I've got a couple of time effects applied to this shot, and notice here in After Effects, I can jump around the timeline and I instantly get the frame returned, the correct frame. So much more predictable now, and I've definitely started including them a lot more in my workflow. And they're also now available inside of the Sapphire Effect Builder as well. You can see the whole list over here on the left-hand side. And I used the time effects in this tutorial where I created this look. And I've just finished another one about how to use time effects and transitions in Sapphire Builder with text, so look out for that one too. And of course, with every new release, we create brand new presets. Sapphire 2024 is no different. We've created a whole range of new presets, including new lens flare looks, and also some great new Sapphire effect presets as well. And one other welcome change in the effect previews is with effects like digital damage, time-based effects. You can now get proper previews so you know exactly what you're looking at and you can choose just what you need. All right, so that's a quick recap of what's new in Sapphire this year. Of course, Sapphire keeps getting better and better, so I can't wait to share with you what we have in store. Have a great 2024, and I look forward to seeing you in my next tutorial.